I often get asked about the secret ingredient in my mash. In fact, it's more about the way you treat the potatoes than the ingredients you put in. And the reason for all of that boils down, pardon the pun, to starch. Now, I've talked before about techniques for water temperature and flavor infusion, but today we're going to look at how by reinventing the masher, we can save time and we'll keep our starches exactly where we want them. Believe it or not, these two plates of mash have been made using the same types of potatoes and the same ingredients. However, those ingredients have been cooked, mashed, and combined using different techniques. Just take a look at how sticky and gluggy this mash is compared to the smooth and silky texture of this one. And when it comes to taste, wow, it's hard to believe they came from the same potato. If treated in the right way, the starch is trapped inside the potato cells, stopping it from causing mayhem and turning your mash into wallpaper paste. Trapping the starch allows for a smooth, light, and velvety mash. But when it comes to the mashing process, I've traditionally done it manually, by first using one of these, a ricer, and then passing it through a fine sieve before mixing in the butter. Now, these processes are precise enough to get a really smooth texture, but gentle enough not to burst the cell walls, causing the starch to ooze out and turning the mash into wallpaper paste. But this manual process can be time-consuming and it leaves you with two big gadgets to wash up. I don't like washing up. It's these kinds of kitchen problems that the designers at Sage and I love to try and solve. And having put it through several extensive workouts in the Fat Duck Experimental Kitchen, we can confidently say that the Sage by Heston Blumenthal Stick Blender Pack is a very clever piece of kit. This variable masher attachment is designed to emulate the action of the ricer and the sieve, but it does it much more efficiently and much more simply. As you can see, the attachment has a paddle and two mashing discs that can, through a turn of the hand, adjust the fineness of the result. On the wider setting, the mash is essentially emulating the action of the ricer, delicately mashing the potatoes into an authentic, rustic, country-style mash that's quite soft, even without having added any butter. Because the paddle gently pushes the potatoes through the plastic mesh, the starches remain mostly intact. Now for some, a slightly chunkier, drier mash is just what the doctor ordered. For you, your mash is now ready, but for me, who likes a creamier, silkier mash, I can select the finest setting, and for an even creamier texture, mix in some butter. On this setting, the electric masher is emulating the sieve, smoothing out the mash while still being delicate on the remaining starches. Heston-style mash from one compact accessory.